Before we wrap up, I just want to ask you, what's it like playing without fans? Because I got to tell you, the fan soundtrack bugs the crap out of me. I cannot, it's like a laugh track to a sitcom. I don't like it. So how is that when you're there and there's no fans?
I think one stadium we went to pumped in a little bit of fan noise, but it was so quiet. Like, it was so quiet that it was almost like, why are you even doing this? And then other ones, like New Orleans, where we just played, they had like some friends and family in the stands, but it was like a few hundred people. And so it's like very quiet. And so on the long run I had, it was just like silent. So I looked back and I was like, is there like a flag? Cause like, it doesn't sound like anyone's celebrating. Like, but
that's so sad. Oh my God.
It was just weird. So, but it's interesting cause it makes you like, you can hear everything. And so it's like, it makes your team kind of get tighter. Cause like, because there's no fans, you know, we're yelling for the defense. The defense is yelling for us. Like, we're getting hyped for each other. And so it almost brings us closer together. So that's kind of a, you know, silver lining positive, but it's definitely weird just being like, big plays happen and it's just like, you just hear like the sidelines, but there's like no fan. Like, usually it's deafening. Like, if the Saints score in the Superdome, it's deafening, right? And it's like, you just don't hear that, you know? So it's definitely weird.
Yeah. But you guys aren't living in like a bubble kind of thing, right? Like, how are you guys doing this? How do they keep it so like safe?
And it actually was going well for a while until recently, but so we get tested every day, and we have contact tracers we have to wear when we're in the building, the facility. So we'll get tested every morning and we have to wear those contact tracers and we have to wear a mask in the building. Masks are mandatory. So basically what they try to do is if a case comes up, someone gets positive, they're immediately quarantined. And then whoever they were in close contact with, they also get quarantined. And then those people that they were in close contact with will get tested and they can't come back until they get two negative tests in a row. You were in close contact, but you didn't get it. You're good to come back. So it's like, it has been wild. It has been crazy. We've had to adjust a lot. It's definitely not convenient. But you know, it is what it is. And we have been relatively good. It would obviously be better if we were in a bubble. But
it's just not conducive to that, right? I mean, football's just not, it's basketball is so much easier to do that.
So much easier. There's less players, you know, you can have court, there's indoor courts, you can have wherever, there's high school, but there's not that many, you can't have that many fields, you know what I mean? And then you can't have that many people on the field because then if you have three different teams probably on the same field, it's going to get tore up on this turf, you know what I mean? So there's a lot more difficult.
Yeah.
There's way more people, you know, we would have to go 4 months in a bubble without seeing people's families. Like, I don't know if that would go over well. I don't know. It has been pretty good though. Obviously we're still playing and we haven't had any positive tests on our team. So that's been good.
No, that's awesome. So when you're,